The ASUS ProArt Studiobook 16 OLED is the most unique creator laptop I've ever used. And ASUS have sponsored this video, so I can show you all about it.
The first thing that makes this laptop different is the ASUS dial, a physical control wheel that sits below the keyboard and above the touchpad. This provides a faster way to interact with apps, literally right at your fingertips. It works very well with the Adobe Suite, allowing you to quickly change things like brush size or scrub through a video timeline. There's support for plenty of other productivity and entertainment apps too, and you can make your own customizations through the ProArt Creator Hub software to really get it working how you want. It may take some getting used to, but having these shortcuts readily accessible to your left hand will help speed up your workflow. It wouldn't be a creator laptop without an epic screen, and the Studiobook does not disappoint here. The 16-inch 120Hz OLED touchscreen provides accurate colors and gets quite bright. OLED screens just look the best in my opinion, always crisp and clear, as they produce true blacks by turning off individual pixels. ASUS also have a number of built-in features to help combat potential OLED burn-in too, so the screen stays in its best possible condition. The haptic touchpad has Stylus Support, and the touchpad has the same 16:10 aspect ratio as the screen to make navigation and input match without on-screen distortion. The haptic clicks feel soft as it barely moves. It took me some getting used to, but ultimately, I'd prefer to use a mouse. The screen also has stylus support too, with 4096 pressure sensitivity levels, and you can bend it right back either for drawing or sharing content with others. The keyboard felt great to type with. It's got 1.4mm of key travel with white backlighting that illuminates all keys and secondary functions with 3 levels of brightness. It feels super sturdy too. Even pushing down hard on the keyboard, it barely flexed at all. The metal lid did not bend at all either. It's so solid, the laptop starts moving first when trying. The Studiobook has a clean matte black finish, and the aluminum alloy build feels great. There's an anti-fingerprint coating, and normally I find these to be a bit of a joke, but it did surprisingly well at staying clean for black metal. It just looks so stealthy considering the performance it's packing. My configuration has Intel's best 24-core laptop CPU right now, paired with Nvidia RTX 4070 graphics and 64 gigs of RAM. The ProArt software lets us pick between these 3 different performance modes. The difference between performance and full speed modes wasn't that big, but full speed was cooler as it ran the fans louder. It's a very impressive result compared to most other laptops tested. It's only really beaten by larger and heavier laptops. Again, impressive performance considering its size. I found it quite portable for a 16-inch laptop. It's not really bigger than most 15-inch options due to the taller 16:10 screen, so there's just more viewable screen space and less bottom chin. It weighs around 5.4 pounds or 2.45 kilos, increasing to 7 pounds or 3.2 kilos with the 240-watt charger. GPU performance was in line with other RTX 4070 laptops tested, actually slightly ahead of others despite having a lower GPU power limit. This is due to Nvidia's voltage limit. The 4070 doesn't really go above 100 watts in most workloads anyway. Although it's not a gaming laptop, it still has a MUX switch, so it's possible to disable Optimus to get better gaming performance. Combined with the RTX 4070 graphics, and the fact that OLED screens have the fastest response times out there, you can absolutely get some gaming done after work. The connectivity options are excellent for creators too, with the left side having an SD card slot, 3.5mm audio combo jack, and a USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type A port. The right has 2 Thunderbolt 4 Type C ports, there's a second USB 3.2 Gen 2 Type A port on this side too, and a Kensington lock. The back has an HDMI 2.1 output, the power input, and 2.5 gigabit Ethernet for fast file transfers. Both Type C ports provide DisplayPort support, so you can connect an external screen to either, and those, as well as HDMI, connect directly to the Nvidia graphics, bypassing Optimus for optimal performance. There's a 1080p camera above the display, and it has IR for Windows Hello Face Unlock.
The quality from both the camera and microphones is definitely above average compared to most other laptops that I've tested.
the speakers sound pretty good too, well above average compared to other laptops with some bass. Inside, we've got the battery down the front, two memory slots just above near the middle, the installed SSD on the left, a spare SSD slot on the right, and Wi-Fi 6E card underneath the SSD. Both PCIe Gen 4 M.2 slots support drives with chips on both sides, so up to 8TB per M.2 slot should be possible. The speeds from the installed 2TB SSD were good, though the SD card slot was not able to get the most out of my V90 card. The cooler has 5 heat pipes with liquid metal applied to the CPU, with plenty of holes underneath for air to get in. Even in a combined CPU plus GPU stress test, I never thought the laptop felt hot to the touch. It was actually really cool around the touchpad, dial, and WASD keys, so where your hands rest while working. The StudioBook is powered by a 4-cell 90Wh battery. Dynamic refresh rate is enabled by default in the MyASUS software, which automatically lowers the screen's refresh rate to 60Hz when you unplug the charger to save battery. This is why the screen briefly flashes black, and it goes back to 120Hz when you plug back in. You've also got the option of enabling battery care mode, which limits the battery charge level to 80% to help improve the lifespan, as it's not ideal to leave it fully charged all the time. Battery life only lasted a little over 4 hours while playing a video, but with Type-C charging, you can get away with a smaller, more portable charger.
Honestly, I'm kind of wondering if I should swap to this laptop for traveling to events like Computex and CES where I need to edit videos on the go. I've always wanted to go for an OLED screen, and this is just more portable than what I have and performs much better. So yeah, it would be great for video editors like me, or those with other intensive workloads like animators, engineers, or graphic designers, just to name a few. You can get more information on ASUS's ProArt Studiobook 16 OLED with the link below. Or otherwise, if you like OLED laptops but you want something smaller, then check out this video next, where I've covered the ASUS S13 OLED. A super portable device, but the screen still looks excellent. I'll see you in that one next.